Hello students, welcome to the online session on design and analysis of algorithms. In this session, we shall take up the concept of Warshall's algorithm to find out the transitive closure. So, transitive closure is a matrix containing the information about the existence of directed path of arbitrary length between the vertices of the given graph. Such a matrix is called as transitive closure of the digraph. It would allow us to determine in constant time whether the vertex J is reachable from vertex I. Means, in any given graph, directed graph, okay, the transitive closure helps us to find whether a path exists from any vertex I to any vertex J. It need not be a adjacency. There may not be a direct connection. Indirect path also, if there is existence, it will allow us to know. Okay, if there is a path, maybe directly or indirectly, arbitrary of any length it may be. Okay, it just makes us to know whether the path exists from any vertex I to any vertex J. As per the standard definition, the transitive closure of a directed graph with n vertices can be defined as the n cross n Boolean matrix T, in which the element in the ith row and jth column is 1 if there exists a non-trivial path, that is a directed path from vertex I to vertex J in the previous matrix, otherwise it is 0. So we shall try to understand the concept and the definition in more deeper sense with some of the illustrations and examples. So this example we'll consider to obtain the transitive closure. So this is the graph, directed graph means digraph given. So they may give you the digraph or they may give you this adjacency matrix. Okay, so if you are given this digraph, you can create this adjacency matrix. We are comfortable with this. Or if they directly give the adjacency matrix, it is well enough. We can directly proceed to find out the transitive closure. Okay, so either of these two they can give. Okay, if they give the graph, you can create the adjacency matrix and then you have to find the transitive closure. This is also a matrix. This contains the possibilities of all existence path from any vertex to any vertex. So how to find this? So we shall illustrate this step by step with an easy procedure. Okay, very easy procedure is that. Fine. Fine. Then the central point of this algorithm is that we can compute all elements of each matrix, because we will be coming across the stages of matrix as we came across the stages of vertex in the multi-stage graph. Okay, because this is also comes under the dynamic programming, we will be solving the problem in number of stages. So the matrix will be evolving in number of stages. So the central point of this algorithm is that we can compute the all element of each matrix RK. Okay, where K is the stage of matrix, K0, K1, K2, like that, the matrix will be improvised in each and every stage from its immediate predecessor matrix. Okay, from if we have the matrix RK minus 1, we can extract or we can develop RK. If you are having R1, I can extract, I can develop R2. If I am having R3, I can get R4, like that. You can compute R4. Okay, so let Rij at kth stage, Rij is the element in ith row and jth column of the matrix RK. Let it be equal to 1. So when it can be equal to 1, this means that there exists a path from I to J with each intermediate vertex K. So what it means? For example, see here. If there is an entry from I to J equals 1, for example, I to J equals 1, it need not be directly connected. they may be connected from an intermediate vertex K. Means in the previous matrix, there may be a path from I to K and K to J. Then we can make I to J as one. This is the law of transitivity. Okay. So here, of course, see here, I to J, it is zero. What it is? Zero. According to the graph we have written, it is zero here. Okay. But can we make it as one? Yes, we can make it as one. When? If we must have to look at the conditions. When I can make it as one? So when I to K and K to J, it has been highlighted here. I to K is one, K to J is one. See here, I to K, there is a path, K to J, there is a path. Then I can define that, or I can compute that I to J, there is a path. It may not be a direct path, but I am having a path existed. This indicates. Okay. So I to K, K to J. Here it defines the algorithm, simplifies your understanding. I to K, K to J. If there is a path like this in the previous matrix, in the recent matrix, you can derive that there is a path from I to J. There is a path from I to J like this. You can see the animated arc or path for your understanding purpose. Okay. So this is the formula or the major statement that we are using entire this Warshall's. That is, for any R in the matrix R, for any vertex or for any edge I to K, okay, it can be made as one if and only if it is already one in previous matrix. For example, if it is one, I can of course directly write it as one. But if it is not one, for example, here it is zero, then I must have to find the other condition, or both of these conditions must be true. What is that? I to K, there may be path, K to J, there may be path. I to K, K to J. So this understanding or this discussion have been indicated by this instruction here. Okay. So again, we shall repeat it. If an element Rij, if an element in the matrix R, I to J, yes, this is the intersection point. If it is already one, it remains one in R K also. For example, it is one in R naught, in R2 also it remains one. But here in this case, it is zero. But can I make it one? Yes. When? The second condition I must have to check. If an element R I J is zero in previous matrix, means in K minus one, it is zero. It has to be changed to one. It has to be changed to one when, if and only if, the element in ith row and kth column, I to K, and element in kth row and jth column, kth row and jth column, both are one in previous matrix R to K minus one. So this provides us the enough understanding with sufficient repetitions of the same concept in various representations. I think the basic concept is clear regarding Warshall's. Okay, using this basic step, we shall take up an example illustration and we shall continue. So applications of Warshall's algorithm for this particular directed graph in the figure. So we have been given with this figure, and with this figure, we shall consider this adjacency matrix. And this adjacency matrix, I'll be considering at R naught. You can even consider this as R naught, or you can take it as RA also. Okay. So in the first step, what we are doing? So we are checking the intermediate path with an intermediate vertex A. We are checking for the path with an intermediate vertex A. Here we checked for the path from I to J with an intermediate vertex as K. We checked whether there is a path from I to J by considering intermediate vertex as K. Okay, I to K, there is a path, K to J, there is a path, and hence we can say that I to J, there is a path. And hence, here also I am doing that. For example, see here, B to C. Okay, before that, what I must have to do? I must have to freeze this. I am in the first step, I am considering only A as intermediate vertex. So both the column and row of the A will be freezed. What next? Okay. And also the diagonals remains unchanged because there is no self slopes, and all it will be remaining 0, 0, 0. So how many places now I am remaining with? So these are all freezed. This is fixed. This cannot be changed in this first step because we are considering A as intermediate vertex. The diagonals are fixed. So how many elements remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 elements we must have to check whether it can be improved or it can be checked for existence of path or not. For example, we shall proceed with whether there is a path from B to C. Whether there is a path from B to C. Okay. So here it is zero. Okay, the first condition is fails, because if it is one, I can write it as one, but here it is zero. But can I make it as one? I must have to see. When can I make it as one? B to C with intermediate vertex as A. Means B to A to C, if there is a path from B to A to C, because now I must have to talk only with respect to A as intermediate vertex. So if B to C there must be a path, means at this point of time I must have to consider there must be a path between B to A to C. B to A is zero, A to C is also zero, so I can reduce the formula like this. Applying this formula, B to C, if there must be a path, if it is 1, so R naught it must have to be 1. But in R naught, this is R naught, it is 0. So that condition is vanished. So I can check second condition, B to A and A to C of R naught. B to A to C, both are 0 and 0, 0, 0 and 0. The condition is, so the overall result is false. And hence, from R naught to R1, this particular entry remains as 0 itself. It cannot be updated. According to the formula we have checked, it cannot be updated. Okay, so here it is already one. Okay, I have retained it as it is. So likewise, you must have to check the condition for each and every 6 elements only, because out of 9 elements, how many elements are there? 16 elements. The first row and first column has been blocked, and the diagonal elements also you cannot change. Only remaining with these 6 elements, first element we have checked, second element is already one. So neglect if it is already one. So only consider zeros. Can we make it as one or not? Okay. For example, we shall take one more example. For example, check D to B here. D to B is zero. Can we make it as one? We shall check. Here it is zero. Hence, directly we cannot make it as one. We must have to check for one more condition. What is one more condition? D to B, considering A as intermediate vertex, means D to A to B. D to B, it gets converted into D to A to B. Okay, what is D to A? It is 1. What is A to B? It is also 1. So, D to A is 1, A to B is 1. So, 1 and 1, it is 1. 0 or 1, it gives 1. So, hence, I can make this particular entry 1 in R1. Extracted from R0, computed from R0. I think the concept is now very clear for you. You can just have a time, analyze. Here it is zero. I cannot directly make it as zero, but I must have to check whether there is an alternate path from intermediate vertex A. D to B I am checking. So D to B, by considering A as intermediate vertex, means D to A, 1, A to B, 1, and hence D to B, I can make it as 1 here. Now this is R1. This is R1. So I can check for all the elements whether any modifications are possible like that. Okay, so now this is R1. Now I must have to update this. Okay, I must have to update this by shifting for next vertex, that is B. I must have to freeze this B row and B column. I must have to freeze, because now in this second step I am considering B as intermediate vertex. B as via path, P as intermediate vertex. Oh, we shall proceed with this. So this matrix we are having now. So we shall forget about the first matrix. Now only this matrix, according to this matrix, we must have to calculate. We must have to forget all the previous matrices. Okay, this matrix we shall consider in stage 2, and we shall try to derive R2. From R1, we shall try to compute R2. Okay, so this row B, a row column is freezed. We cannot change any values in this. And all the diagonal values also freezed. They remain zero as it is. So we shall just check arbitrary with some of the examples I have already indicated. For example, A to C, can I make it zero? Sorry, can I make it one in R2? A to C. So it is zero. I cannot directly make it one. So A to C via B means A to B, B to C. We shall check. A to B, it is 1. Fine. But B to C, it is 0. Both must be 1. Both must be 1. And both are not 1 here. If 1 is false, if 1 is 0, the total result will be 0, because this is AND condition. AND condition. Okay. So, A to C remains 0 as it is. We shall check A to D. So, A to D is 0. So, directly I cannot make it 1. we must have to check with intermediate vertex, which is the intermediate vertex now here B. So A to D means A to B, B to D. A to B is 1, B to D is 1, both are 1, and hence I make it as 1. Clear? Now this, what is this? D to D. Here D to D is 0, but from B, is it possible? From B means D to B, B to D. With respect to this matrix, here it is 1, here it is 1. So both are 1, I can make it as 1. D to D now becomes 1. D to D now becomes 1. I think it is clear for you. D to D is 0, but through intermediate vertex B, D to B, B to D, it is 1. Because in the graph, you can observe there is a path from D to D. Of course, there is not a self loop. There is not a self edge, but there is a circuit D to A to B, B to D. So there is a path from D to D itself, and hence it must have to be indicated. There is a path from D, I can reach D. Of course, there is a path from B to B because I can reach A from A, I can reach B from B, but not in this single step. Okay, fine. We shall proceed then. This is R2. From this R2, now this will be shifted to next stage. I must have to freeze column C, row C, because C is considered as intermediate vertex now. We shall proceed by taking this as the reference graph for our next calculation. This as the reference matrix. Okay, from R2, I must have to extract, or I must have to calculate R3. I must have to obtain R3. So how? So see here, from the graph, we cannot go anywhere from C. There is no path from C to A, C to B, C to D, C to C. So I cannot move anywhere via C. Via C means with having intermediate vertex as C, I cannot go anywhere. So you can, even if they apply the formula and check the concepts as per the discussed procedure, there will be no updations at all. There will be no updations at all. R2 will be moving to the next stage, R3, as it is. No modifications in the matrix. I think it is clear. Next, this is R3. Now we shall proceed for next step by considering next vertex as intermediate vertex, that is the D. After completing the R3, we will be proceeding by incrementing the stage to D. We will be freezing D through Dth column. Here this is the reference matrix now. This is the reference matrix R3. From R3, I must have to obtain R4. So D is the last row, last vertex A, B, C, D, and this will be the last stage of our discussion. After this, we will be obtaining the final matrix, that is called as transitive closure. Okay, we shall check. A to A, this is 0. A to A, this is 0. Right? So now the diagonal elements are opening up. Now the diagonal elements are opening up in the last stage. We can consider now. So A to A, can I make it as 1? Here it is 0. I cannot directly make it as 1. But is there an alternate path via D? Is there an alternate path via D? Because this is the stage of considering intermediate vertex only as D. So A to A means I must have to check for A to D, D to A. Correct? So A to D it is 1, D to A it is 1. So 1 and 1 I can make it as 1. So A to C, can I check? A to C means A to D, D to C. A to D it is 1, D to C it is 1, and hence I can make it as 1. Okay, we shall check last one more. B to C, B to C is 0, but alternate path existence I must have to check. B to C means B to D, D to C. B to D, yes, 1. D to C is also 1. So 1 and 1 I can make it as 1. Like this, I shall update all the entries, and this becomes R4, and the procedure stops here because we are having only 4 vertices, and this is called as transitive closure with all the paths indicated. Wherever there is a reachability existence, I can reach A from A. Of course, there is a path loop. I can reach B from B. Again, there is a path because this is also included in the circuit. I can reach D from D, but I cannot reach C from C. I cannot reach C from C, and hence this particular remains 0 as it is. okay, and from C I cannot reach anywhere, and it is completely zero. If I reach C, this is the dead end point. I cannot go anywhere. I can, and from all the vertices, I can reach all other vertices. Okay, this has been clearly indicated in this matrix, and this is called as transitivity closure. So as I already told you, this graph will be given for you in the question and asked to obtain the transitive closure. What I must have to obtain? The transitive closure. So you must have to first derive this distance matrix or adjacency matrix. Sorry, I must have to obtain this adjacency matrix from this given graph, and from this adjacency matrix, the adjacency matrix only is considered as R or not. As it is, considered the adjacency matrix as R not, and start by considering A as intermediate vertex, then B, then C, then D. You can also consider RA, RB, RC, RD instead of R0, R1, R2 like that. After going through all these stages, you will be obtaining one matrix that is called as transitive closure matrix. And this is the answer for this answer. For if it is proper, you will be getting the full marks. And you must have to show this stepwise. From this matrix, we are obtaining this with some of the necessary explanation you have to make. Why you are making, for example, here it is zero, but you are making it one here. Why you are making it one here? It is zero, you are making it one here. This particular entry, why this is one, why not other? So wherever there is a modifications or wherever there is a conversions from zero to one, you must have to just mention it a point why you are making it as a one. And in step wise, in stage wise, you must have to proceed to obtain the final transitive closure. This is the easiest question. Okay, so we shall just have a look at the importance of this topic as per the VT question papers. Okay, so before that, topic at VTU exam question papers. So what has been asked? Test trace the following graph using Warshall's algorithm. 1, 2, 3, 4. The same graph we have discussed now. So we had taken ABCD. They have given 1, 2, 3, 4. For 8 marks in 2017. Again, the same matrix again. The third question, the last question in figure 8.0, question 8B. A to B, D, C, the same matrix we have discussed now, the same graph. That has been given two times. 2018, July, 2020, January. So total, the same discussion we have, the topic has been asked for three times now, totally. Okay, and one more, define transitive closure. In the first slide only, we have discussed the definition and understanding of transitive closure, what you mean by transitive closure, and write the Warshall's algorithm. Write the Warshall's algorithm to compute the transitive closure, find its efficiency. Okay, its efficiency is NQ. Okay, we shall discuss it in the later stages. Okay, so write the algorithm they have asked one time. So we shall just brief out the algorithm. It is very easy procedure. We shall see what if any other question paper. Yes, again, some more question papers. 2019 January, 2019 July. Means, I think I have already told you, I am referring some of the previous question paper. In the question paper that I am having, it has been appeared 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Means it has been appeared 6 times recently in six previous examinations. This all the question paper contains this question. All the question paper contains this question, and it is so easy, and it has been asked for 8 marks. You must have to write it very neatly, without miss, stepwise, with sufficient explanation. So there is a matrix given here. Instead of graph, they haven't given you a matrix. Which is this matrix? You must have to, you can, if of course, write a graph for this, or you can directly start, proceed from this matrix itself. No problem. We are not required the graph at all. Okay, no need of worrying about the graph. Directly proceed with this matrix. Define transitive closure of a graph. Write the Warshall's algorithm. Again, they have asked to compute the transitive closure. Apply the algorithm defined by the following adjacency matrix. Okay, next, define the transitive closure again. Find the transitive closure of the graph whose adjacency matrix is given. So there are various questions, various adjacency matrix have been given for you. So you have to take these as assignments as previous sessions we are practicing, and you complete this and add it in your assignments. So before closing the session, we are having some of the minutes remaining. So with a very few time, we shall briefly discuss the algorithm, which is very simple and easy because we have already discussed the procedure. Okay, we'll be able to understand the algorithm very soon. So implements Warshall's algorithm for computing transitive closure. So this is the main agenda and the purpose of the algorithm. What is the input? Input is the adjacency matrix A of the digraph with n vertices. Okay, it is simple. Then what next? What is the output? Output is the transitive closure of the digraph. What is the transitive closure? Of course, this is also a matrix. Adjacency matrix is the input. Transitive closure matrix is the output. So for I equals 1 to n, j equals 1 to n, I must have to do. I equals 1 to n, j equals 1 to n. Because for matrix, I am dealing. So the entire matrix has to be processed. How many times? K equals 1 to n. K equals 1 to n. Because if k are the number of vertices, K is the number of vertices. So n times means for all the vertices I must have to process. For all the vertices, if one time I complete this nested for loop, two nested for loop, I and j, means I will be obtaining one minimum, one edge at a time. Okay, for k equals 1 to n, I equals 1 to n, j equals 1 to n, I must have to apply this formula for that matrix. What is this formula? We shall see. So after completing, I must have to return R. What is R? This is the transitive closure. The name of the matrix is R. Okay, see, this formula we have already discussed. We shall apply the same formula here. So, for at a particular matrix R, we are calculating or we are checking for the particular entry I to J. Okay, so in K minus 1 means previous matrix, if it is already 1, I can assign as it is. Here in K minus 1, in previous matrix, I to J is 1, means I can write I to J 1 here. Or if it is 0, means I must have to check. In previous matrix, there is a path I to J, not directly, using intermediate vertex I to K and K to J. In previous matrix, K minus 1 means previous matrix. I to K, there may be 1, it must be 1, and condition must be there. Again, in the previous matrix, K to J, it must be 1. So if it is 1 here and 1 here, so I can write 1 to I to J in the recent matrix. So we have discussed this formula many number of times in the previous discussion. So I think the formula and the complete algorithm is easy for you to understand now. So this is the simple algorithm you have to write when you have been asked for Warshaw's algorithm. Of course, they will not ask only the algorithm. Along with algorithm, you have to define what is transitive closure and you have to apply that algorithm for the particular given. Either digraph will be given or the matrix will be given like this. So this is the simple, beautiful, important topic that you can be confident and practice for your understanding. Okay, so I hope this session was useful for you and it will help you to score good marks in your examination. So as I told, consider all the question that I had provided as the assignment and complete it as soon as possible. Thank you for listening. So we shall all meet again soon in the next session, and in the next session we shall discuss about Floyd's algorithm. So it is almost 90% similar to this concept. Okay, so and it is one of the important, beautiful concept. We shall discuss that concept in the next session. Thank you.